By the way, you can roughly estimate how old the new incarnations of the Nazis are nowadays. If they all died in 1946, their approximate age of majority was somewhere in the 1960s and 1970s. Precisely at that time, the wave of neo-Nazism significantly increased. The first large neo-Nazi unions appeared, and new ideological leaders of the neo-Nazism emerged. Nazism gained its new round. Is that a coincidence? By the way, the top Nazi leader had bearer accounts, and by a strange coincidence, those accounts were cashed in the 1960s and 1970s. Who took this money? If those were some relatives, why did they wait so long? Why didn't they withdraw the money immediately? Let's suppose they didn't want to show up straight away that they were using Nazi funds. They could have withdrawn the money little by little. Anyway, the investigation wasn't aware of the existence of those accounts, because if they knew, they would have blocked those accounts a long time ago. So everything is simple here. The Nazis kept those accounts for themselves, for their new incarnation in this life. In fact, by those accounts, one can track what names the reincarnated Nazis have in our time. So those